One afternoon, Peter and John were going to the temple to pray. A man who had never walked was at the temple gate begging for money. He asked Peter and John for help. Peter said, "I don't have silver or gold, but I will give you what I have. In Jesus' name, get up and walk." Peter took the man by the hand and helped him up. The man walked, he jumped, he praised God. The people who saw the miracle were amazed. Peter said, "Why are you staring? Our power did not make this man walk. God made this man walk." Peter and John used the opportunity to tell the people about Jesus. It was important for the people in the crowd to understand exactly what Jesus had done for them. Peter told how Jesus died on the cross and was raised from the dead on the third day. Then, Peter encouraged the people to repent and turn away from their sins. The temple leaders were upset with Peter and John. The leaders arrested the two disciples and put them in jail. But 5,000 men who heard the message believed in Jesus. The next day, Peter and John were brought before the high priest and the other leaders. The temple leaders asked many questions and were amazed that the men with little education could preach so powerfully. The temple leaders wanted to know how Peter and John healed the man who could not walk. Peter and John explained that the man was healed in the name of Jesus Christ. The leaders were confused and could not decide what to do. Finally, they ordered Peter and John not to preach about Jesus anymore and not to tell anyone else about Jesus. Peter and John said, "We cannot stop speaking about what we have seen and heard." The temple leaders threatened Peter and John again and then let them go.
Hard-hitting, investigative, you're watching Mooseberry Uncovered.
You're watching Mooseberry Uncovered on the Mooseberry Academy Network. I'm your host, Stephanie, and I'm out here for one thing, the real story. The Holy Spirit, you can't see it, you can't touch it, but it somehow helps you? I, for one, am skeptical. I mean, what exactly does the Holy Spirit help you do? Math? Juggle? Create a robot army to help you take over the world? If that's the case, I may personally be interested in hearing more about this Holy Spirit.
Making robot armies doesn't seem like the type of thing the Holy Spirit would want to be a part of. Think more along the lines of making a good choice.
Personally, I do think making a robot army is a good choice.
Then think along the lines of accomplishing something worthwhile.
Again, personally, I think a robot army is a totally worthwhile thing.
Then maybe you should think of the opposite thing of what you think is good.
It's simple. The Holy Spirit helps Christians do the things we should do.
Like chores or homework?
Well, stuff that's more important than that stuff.
Oh, okay. Like eating, or sleeping, or breathing? The Holy Spirit helps you do that stuff?
You are not making this easy. Yes, those are important, but that's not how the Holy Spirit helps. That's how God helps. He made us all the way we are to breathe oxygen and consume nutrients for energy, and to sleep when our minds and bodies need rest. But the Holy Spirit's help is mainly focused on helping us understand God's plan for salvation. He helps people follow Jesus and tell people all around the world about him.
Helping share Jesus with the world? What could that possibly entail? Did Jesus have some amazing recipes? Something with fish and bread, perhaps? My investigation continues.
So, the Holy Spirit helps us share Jesus' love with others. I think you know that's what we've been trying to say, or whatever. Jesus showed people how to live when he walked the earth. Those instructions are in the Bible. And it's our job as Christians to keep sharing the stuff Jesus wants everyone to know. Like how much he loves us and how he died for our sins and rose again that we might have eternal life and how we should live for him and how to treat each other. Sometimes the Holy Spirit reminds us of what we know about Jesus, and sometimes it guides us to find new stuff we should know about Jesus, and sometimes it gives us the confidence we need to share what we know about Jesus with others.
The Mooseberry students seem to believe the Holy Spirit helps Christians share Jesus with others. But is there more to it? I, for one, need to find out. I also need to find out where the scrap metal is in case I need to create another robot army. Not to necessarily take over the world or anything. I just think it'll help me think. Until next time, I'm Stephanie, and you're watching Mooseberry Uncovered on the Mooseberry Academy Network.
That was another very exciting episode of Mooseberry Uncovered.